Gopakumara continued, "Intoxicated by drinking the sweet nectar of the Lord's words, I did not have the power to recite any prayers, to understand anything, or to do anything. In the Lord's presence came some cowherd boys, like myself, who were playing flutes. Very affectionate, they took me in their midst and encouraged me to play the flute. In many ways, playing on my favorite flute from Govardhan Hill, I pleased Lord Madhava, who is an ocean of artistic skill and a treasure house of mercy, and who was surrounded by his associates. At a certain time, they all left. By the goddess of fortune's order, they took me outside, although I was not willing to go." Sanatan Goswami explains that this was the time for the Lord to take his meal. "Great opulences surrounded me, but I shunned them. I stayed as a cowherd boy, as I had before. The opulences there have forms of Sat, Chit, and Ananda. They are independent and are manifest as they like. Whether opulences are manifested or not, humbleness is present as a natural feature in Vaikuntha. By the strength of my previous activities, I considered humble worship of the Lord eternal happiness. Then in my heart, I decided that, by the Lord's mercy, I had attained the highest fruit of all I had done in all my births. What rare happiness! What a glorious place! What a wonderful Lord! What wonderful mercy! By the Lord's mercy, I fanned him with a chamara whisk and performed other personal services. When I played the flute, his glance brought me eternal bliss. By the strength of my previous actions, sometimes I would call out, 'O Krishna, O Gopal,' again and again. With many prayers, I would always sing the great glories of the Lord's pastimes in Gokul. Smiling and laughing, the residents of Vaikuntha took me outside, and, their hearts melting with love, again and again spoke to me many words of instruction. The residents of Vaikuntha said,
'Don't address the Lord of Lords in that way. Don't praise him in that way. With eloquent verses, you should praise his real, limitless greatness. To kill the demons and protect the devotees, the Lord cheated Kamsa and disguised himself as a cowherd boy. The devotees do not take these disguises of the Lord very seriously. In the beginning of devotional service, it may be right, but we do not glorify the Lord in that way.'
Then some of the other residents said, 'The Lord, whose pastimes are difficult to understand, has pastimes like that. There is no fault in glorifying him in that way.'" Sanatan Goswami explains that pastimes discussed here are pastimes like the Lord's protecting cows. These pastimes are not like his creation of the material universes. They have no contact with the illusory potency, Maya. Someone here may protest. When the Lord protects cows, sometimes he is stung by brambles as he wanders in the forest. What kind of happy pastime is that? This objection is answered here by the word Dirbhoda Charitasya. Because the Lord is the supreme controller, it is not possible to understand his activities perfectly. Then some great souls rebuked them all and said,
"Why do you speak as fools? Out of love for his devotees, Lord Krishna will do anything. Glorifying his deeds is a great virtue. It pleases the Lord."
Gopakumar continued, "These words made me first embarrassed and then pleased. Still, my heart was not perfectly satisfied, because I could not see my worshipable Lord, Lord Gopal's lotus feet, form, pastimes, and everything else. I became like a poor wretch. Then I saw the Lord of Vaikuntha, who is the crest jewel of the all-knowing, become Krishna, the joy of Nanda. I saw Lakshmi and Dara become Radharani and Chandravali and the Lord's associates become the boys of Braj. Sanatana Goswami explains that this was not just a vision in meditation. Gopa Kumar actually saw this. When I could no longer see the Lord enjoying pastimes in the land of Braj with his associates, my heart became unhappy. Sometimes I would see him enjoying pastimes with the cows in the gardens there. But then again, I would see him as before, as a master sitting on his throne. Still, because I was aware that he is the Supreme Lord, because I could remember coming to Vaikuntha, and because of the presence of great awe and reverence that killed spontaneous love, my heart was not satisfied. In meditation, by Lord Gopal Dev's mercy, I would embrace him, kiss him, and enjoy pastimes with him in many ways. Now that the Lord was present before my eyes, I was unhappy, for although I desired these things, I could not attain them. Sometimes the Lord would go to a secluded place with his intimate associates. Then everyone else would lament for not seeing the Lord. I asked what the Lord was doing. Concealing what they knew, as if it were a great secret, no one told me clearly. At that moment, the Lord of the universes appeared and was visible again. Then that lamentation died, and an ocean of joy overflowed. The glory of that place killed whatever suffering stayed in my heart, as the sun kills the darkness. Whenever my heart became unhappy, as it had been many times before, when it could not attain its desire, I considered what was the cause of this malady, and the perfection of Vaikuntha cured it at once. I said to my mind, "Nothing is better than residence in Vaikuntha. Don't doubt. What more could you ask for? O fickle mind, leave your restless nature behind. No result is better than this. Think about the hundreds of reasons for this, and to become peaceful." As I was explaining this to my mind, I saw that I was made of eternity, knowledge, and bliss, and that I eternally experienced wonderful, intense, transcendental bliss by worshiping the Lord in Vaikuntha. In this way, sometimes happy and sometimes distressed, I lived in Vaikuntha.